Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. To my dear sister feeling upset over the arrival of her monthly period just few minutes before the Maghrib Adhan, I say to you, do not be sad or upset, but rather listen to this beautiful hadith from Rasulullah alayhi salam, which is full of good news for you and I. Rasulullah alayhi salam says that when a slave of Allah suffers from illness or set on a journey, he is credited with the equal of whatever good deeds he used to do when he was healthy or at home. The meaning of this hadith, dear sister, is that when a slave of Allah happened to be used to a certain ibadah, but because he fell ill or he embarked on a journey, and so he wasn't able to carry out that ibadah he was used to, Allah will still go ahead and credit him with exact reward, just as if he observed the ibadah. Now, dear sister, do you think that Allah the Most Merciful will reward him or her who has the intention of an ibadah but wasn't able to attempt it due to some obstacles, or he or she who used to engage in an ibadah but due to sickness or a travel, he or she wasn't able to carry it out, and then deny you who fasted a prescribed day but was hindered from completing it due to a fitra or a nature he imposed on you as a woman? Never. Our Lord is never unjust to his servants. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Your reward as a believer in the sight of Allah will never go lost. Therefore, accept his decree and carry on with the break from fasting and prayer he blessed you with, and never forget to engage yourself with other ibadat that are allowed to be observed by a menstruating woman, such as recitation of Quran, dhikr, dua, sadaqah, feeding of a fasting soul, etc. May Allah accept our ibadat and bless our Ramadan and count us among those that will be freed from the hellfire. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.